Alright guys, welcome to Life is Strange. Most YouTubers have already played this game, but since it's not reliant on any one story, it's different for just about everybody because there's so many different choices, I thought I would play it. If you don't know what Life is Strange is, it basically it takes your decisions into account and it develops a story around it. And I have actually played the first part of this game, or maybe the second part as well, back in January. But my game save got corrupted, and since then I don't remember any of the choices, and I don't really remember anything that happened. So I figured starting a new game save wouldn't really be the worst thing in the world. So anyways, let's just start playing, because I really want to play this game. Life is Strange is a story-based game that features player choice. The consequences of all your in-game actions and decisions will impact the past, present, and future. Choose wisely. As I said. That scared me.
Pieces of time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay, I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller?
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Look.
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
Oh, I have to. Okay, I got it.
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
Mr. Jefferson's the teacher. You can hear the class.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? And frankly,
it's selfie.
Shh, shh, shh. Keep that.
I do love my analog camera.
Seriously, though.
I should take a quick picture now.
And capture you in a moment of desperation.
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century.
Isn't that too
but
easy?
I like it old school. If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
What would they think? Let's go back to the first page. July 10th, 2013. I got accepted to Blackwell. If words could dance, we'd be a rave. I'm going to Blackwell again. Okay. So this is it. I'm leaving Seattle to go back to Arcadia Bay. Okay, so Max is from Seattle, and we are in Arcadia Bay at Blackwell Academy. Shit is crazy with a K here. I didn't realize how much crap I had to pack until I pack all my crap. She just wants things to be different. Oh, crap. I'm getting a lot about crying. But I'm here now, and this is starting my new life, sweet dreams. She says on September 2nd, I can't wait to decorate. I did meet some of my dorm mates, though I still can't remember names. The day after, Blackwell sucks ass. I told myself not to whine so soon, but damn, the day started like Christmas morning. I barely had any dreams because I was so pumped to start my first day of my new life. Like a dork, I couldn't figure out what to wear, so I chose what was on the floor. I was no good with names and faces right away, so I picked up some names like Kate, Brooke, Taylor, Alyssa. And how could I forget Victoria Chase? Rich, stylish, titled. I could feel instant judgment when she looked at my raggedy ass clothes, as if I'm not at Blackwell Street. A fashion pose. Maybe I'm being extra crispy sensitive, but I think Victoria wants life to be like her own reality show. So, okay, I'm gonna stop reading this. Up here we've got 4 people. I'm guessing these fill up as you meet people. We have Max. This is our character. My name is Max Caulfield. I want to be a photographer. Okay. This is Jefferson. Mark Jefferson, one of the best photographers in the world, and he's the teacher. Okay. Kate. This is the girl that they just hit with a piece of paper, isn't it? I've forgotten. I've ever even seen Kate Marsh smile or laugh in the past month. She's really sweet and nice, even though other students make fun of her abstinence campaign. Oh, okay, abstinence, sorry. Even if they act immature, everybody at Blackwell are seniors, not high school freshmen. She gets a lot of shit. In fact, I know she's involved in a lot of religious groups, but she doesn't preach to me, so I don't care. But she's been extra quiet and introverted the past couple of weeks. She looks like she's in zombie mode. I wish I could help her, but I can barely help myself. I wonder if all the bullying has worn her down. I can see how it would. I have to make an effort to talk to her more often. Maybe invite her to tea or a movie. Although she's an adult, I bet she's not allowed to watch R-rated films. Oh, I think this is the one I added. Victoria. Shush, I'm dreaming. Then there's Victoria Chase, the elite of Blackwell Academy, and a total bitch. I hate saying that, I just don't know why somebody who's rich and beautiful needs to be so fucking mean. 18-year-olds at prestigious academy should be evolving into artists and scholars, not reality show contestants. Victoria does everything for maximum drama. She actually wastes her time calling me out in class and taunting Kate Marsh. Okay, so she's mean. I don't want to keep reading because I want to play the game. This is the episode we're in. Oh, there's a map of Arcadia Bay. That's cool. So we're at school right now. This is Blackwell Academy where we are. Interesting. SMX. Oh, we can see who we're texting. Okay. Got a text from my dad. Have a very special 18th birthday. You're an adult now, but you're still a little girl. Check your account. Don't blow it all at once. Oh, he sent us money. That's awesome. Text from Kate. Scroll up. Hey Max, you around? Always. You okay? Did you want to get tea later today? Absolutely. I'll be free after 4. Talk to you later. But we never texted again, so I don't know what happened. Mom. Happy birthday, Maxine. We can't believe it's been 18 whole years since you were brought to us. XO. Is that hugs and kisses or kisses and hugs? Doesn't really matter. Alright, do you want to meet for coffee after school? Any excuse not to study. Please, make sure that you... Okay, so on October the 2nd... He sent us those, we didn't respond. Make sure to check out Necromantic on my flash drive. Mwahaha. Hey, Mad Max, let's bust shit up. Wait, I have to study for a physics test, so if we bust anything, we also have to measure its velocity. Don't ignore this message. Oh, so we're just completely ignoring this kid. Oh, that's so mean.
What if Arbus chose to capture people at the height of their beauty or innocence?
My little camera bag is battered, but still kicking.
So, she could have taken another approach.
Let's take a selfie.
I have to admit, I'm not a big fan of her work. I prefer Robert Frank.
Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie.
See,
a dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition.
It doesn't make sense.
And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
You're asking me?
You're asking me? Let me think.
You either know this or not, Max.
Chill, dude.
Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes. A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What?
The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius.
Let's just learn about this.
You can find out all about him in your textbook, or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Dang. It's sort of a hard ass, huh? Okay, notebook.
Victoria doesn't waste a second kissing. Even her school books are gift wrapped. I can't believe she made fun of me in class. What is she, 15 years old? And people laughed.
You there.
Looks like somebody was already working on this. Cool.
Neo Noir. Let's talk to Kate.
Hi, Kate.
Oh.
You said we have to get her attention in the journal.
Perhaps. You have just by participating. By putting yourself out there in the world.
You seem quiet today.
Just thinking too much.
I don't want anybody to feel excluded from this process.
I hear that. Want to go grab a cup of tea and bitch about life?
Thanks, but not today. I have to go over homework.
No worries. Let's hang later.
Sure.
Okay, I'm gonna do what it said. Look at this shit.
Now I wish I wouldn't have read this.
Oh, what did it say?
Purge.
Dear Kate, we love your... Did I say porn video? Porn video, what? XOXO, what? It does say porn video. What the hell? Etched mark. I don't even know what it says. It's Rachel something? I didn't even look at it, I just took a picture. Oh man, can I not look at it again? Oh, tab. Oh, we can see all our pictures. Yeah. Oh, it did say Rachel, Amber, love forever. Okay. Let's go look at the tablet, I don't even care.
I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell.
Oh, geez, 5,300 dollar camera. JPEG images, PNGs, better. God, okay. Let's get out of here. Oh, books. Look.
So cool that we can check these out anytime. The Decisive Moment by Henri Cartier-Bresson? That's rare. Man, he even has the best plasma HDTV for a class monitor. Here's the poster for the contest. Mr. Jefferson really expects me to enter. Why? I don't know if I'm ready for my 15 minutes of infamy.
Okay.
I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
They're all red. I don't have any time.
I didn't have any time. Way too much homework.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you. But life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images. To frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
Okay.
Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me.
Yeah, to the teacher.
This is ridiculous. I always get so shy and nervous around Mr. Jefferson.
Oh, do you have a crush on Mr. Jefferson?
You can never escape the lighthouse here.
That's not...
Even in pictures, the forest around here always looks mysterious.
Is there anything else? I think we got everything. Hammer.
Whoa, Mr. Jefferson is not messing around with that monster. He probably paid 20 grand for that camera. I bet he gets pristine digital images. But I still dig my little instant camera.
Oh yeah, she has.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
I'm not paying 100.
You always
welcome to the real world.
Just cute?
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture.
Oh.
Because Max tells everybody to see
send you a special picture. Ooh.
She plays it so sharp.
I need a serious timeout in the bathroom.
So they're talking about
splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that girl. It's so fucking boring.
What am I doing?
She's so fucking shy.
Yeah. Yeah, mute. Turn them out, Max. Oh, dude, this music's so good. Oh, am I gonna get... Hopefully there won't be a copyright issue here. I'll look into it. I hope not, because I don't want to have to turn this down.
Evan doesn't say much to me, but his photos are very cool.
Yeah, I really hope there's no issue. To all of you.
Dana is on my floor too. She's such an archetypal, gorgeous cheerleader. They must make them in a factory. I shouldn't be so catty. It looks like she's been gone for months.
Driving a car by the seaside. Missing since 2013. Well, I don't know. Depends on when this game takes place. Rachel Amber. Bathroom. To all of you, I really hope that American music is so good.
Empty, good. Nobody can see my meltdown, except for me.
All right. Rachel.
Now, who would bother to write that crap?
Oh, that's the missing girl, Rachel. Well, Rachel. Rachel Anderson. Look.
The last time I got a flu shot, I got the flu. Fuck you. I feel like the universe is taunting me everywhere I go today. It all started with that bizarro dream in class.
It's funny though.
Am I going crazy?
I like that.
Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift.
Are you saying that sarcastically? It's not a bad picture.
Fuck it.
Well, shit.
When a door closes, a window opens. or something like that.
Oh, does this game have the butterfly effect?
Okay, like, well, you don't get a photo op like until, this every day.
Like, Until Dawn did? Hopefully not in such like, bad weather. Okay, we'll take a photo of it. So, yeah. Oh man, I love this game. Why is this dude in here? It's clearly a women's room.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school.
No
if I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss.
Blow up the school? What? All right, this
so
crazy.
What do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
Check behind me.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Where'd you get that?
Yo.
What are you doing?
Put that down.
Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho! No!
Oh. That did not just happen.
Whoa.
What
the fuck? How can that be?
What just
I was
happened?
In the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
As he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us.
I already heard
so
this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color.
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now,
shit!
Can you give me an example of a photographer
I cannot believe
who
this.
Captured the human condition in black and white?
Okay, if I'm crazy, anybody? I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane. Can I actually reverse time?
Where did you go, Victoria? Why Arbus?
Hold right, Master. I want to see that thing come up. Am I actually doing it?
I did
now,
it.
Can you
I actually did it.
Of a photographer who perfectly
I'm
captured
a human
the human
time
condition
machine.
In black and white.
Yes, we're all right now, but okay.
Anybody?
Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Oh, we took a selfie.
Because of
last
her images
time.
Of hopeless faces.
When I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question.
Yep.
If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
What kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not
of
dreaming
course,
this.
As you all know, the
it's
photo
real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation
so
was
I can go
first
back in time.
Images for selfie expression.
What if that girl so, isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point
can I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for.
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max. Since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
Oh, it was Daguerrean. But, okay, I have to go to the bathroom.
I'm sorry, but I really have to use the bathroom.
Nice try, Max. But you're not going to get away that easy.
Oh, come on.
We can talk more after class. Is there anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me after class. And I need time to save that girl.
I remember this one.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Shut up.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind again?
Oh, I'm going
give
to.
Give him the right answer.
Can I go faster? Oh, I can't. Shit.
I can go faster. Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self portraits.
The Daguerrean process.
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture like hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of everyone. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together.
Okay,
Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see.
Gotta give her that support, you know, man.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Yeah, that's a really...
Yes, Victoria, you still have to...
Nice answer, Max. Are you okay? You look pale.
Kate, did we talk at all today?
This is the first time. What's wrong?
I'm sorry, I'm just dripping. Too much stress.
I know the feeling.
I just really think Everyday Heroes is an important cultural event.
I wish we didn't. I do have to go, but we can talk later if you want.
I'll see how I feel. Thanks, Max.
Okay, that
this
works.
Is just a bump on a bigger road. I don't want anybody to feel excluded from this process, but...
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Victoria's such a bitch. I'm not avoiding it.
I'm not avoiding, just...
Biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Yep.
Exactly.
Max... Don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you.
Okay. They want us... I'll press control and it'll do it automatically.
Happy to feel excluded from this process, but I also want everybody to know that this photographic world is...
Excuse me.
Let one of photog-
okay. Oh, bring the quote.
I'm on top of it.
Do the quote that he said.
I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
That sounds so cheap.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers. Good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
Oh, yes, faith. Yay. Oh. Okay, let's get down to that.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please. I can't tell anybody.
See, the way she
don't
said
think
that,
I'm crazy.
Did she actually have to go to the bathroom?
When can you?
I have to get my education.
Oh, they're bullying
Yo,
him.
Yo, Daniel. You remember that it's payday?
Payday. Are they getting lunch money? What? Okay.
Okay, Max. Retrace every step. I washed my face, I shredded my photo, then the butterfly flew in,
we looked
and
at
I took
that
a photo.
Thanks, Mom.
Leave them
the
out of this
girl.
Bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on,
don't
put that thing down!
Tell me what to do! Oh. I'm so sick!
I need a hammer to break it open!
Control me! You...
I don't want her to...
Of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody
oh, hammer.
Would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Okay.
Would...
Hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
No way.
Don't ever touch me again, freak.
Damn.
Another shitty day.
Can you even
that
put
did
it
not
some,
happen.
Put it away?
This cannot be real.
Okay, let's get out of here.
I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
What do you think
I
I'm doing?
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen.
What?
The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone, and please turn off that alarm since that's your job.
All right, calm down, dude. Dude, look at his head. I'm not gonna even talk to him. Actually, I sort of feel like I should talk to him. You know, there's only a guy with a gun.
You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max,
dude,
talk to me.
Why are all the adults so hide the truth?
I just got sick in class. Female trouble.
Except you're wandering around like a zombie. And do you think that's the first time a student has used that line on me?
It's the truth. I felt dizzy in Mr. Jefferson's
just
class.
Just tell me what you're hiding. You can trust me.
There's nothing to hide. I got sick. It happens, you know.
There's that teen toot again. You know, I've heard enough. Don't think I don't know what goes
yeah,
on
what?
Around here. You've only been here for 3 weeks, and you're already causing conflict. I don't think your parents will approve when they find out.
What?
Now get outside with class.
Oh, I'm rewinding
please.
That.
No, he does not buy that at all. I may have just flushed my scholarship down the toilet. Yes, I could rewind and actually tell him the truth.
You look a little stressed out.
Undo your choices.
Are you okay?
I'm...
Skip. Okay, we're gonna report Nathan this time.
I just saw Nathan Prescott waving a gun around in the girls' room.
Nathan Prescott. You sure?
Yes. He was in the bathroom talking to himself with a gun. I saw everything. He was babbling like crazy.
Okay, slow down. Slow down. So now you saw this without him seeing you.
I was hiding behind a stall. I have the right to be there. It's the girls' room.
I know. I just want to be completely clear what happened. Mr. Prescott happens to be from the town's most distinguished family. And
oh
one of Blackwell's most honored
yeah,
students.
I have the same reaction, sir.
So it's hard for me to see him brandishing a weapon in the girls' bathroom. So what happened next?
Then he left. I ran out here wondering what to do. Are you gonna bust him?
This is a serious charge. I'll look into the matter personally. Thank you for bringing it to my attention.
Call the cops.
That's it? After what I told
you? We'll continue this discussion later, in my office. Please go outside with the rest of your class now, Miss Caulfield.
Of course this academic drone won't do anything, since the Prescott family owns Blackwell now. Should I rewind and change my story?
I already tried that. I could just not say anything to him. I don't know what the worst... Should I roll? It says right there, gun-free zone, right next to my head there. Do I want to rewind, though, and not say anything to him at all? Because we can do that.
Max, you better go on outside now.
I'm going to keep my story the way it is. Nice campus. I guess it's where the prestigious school though, so. Yeah, this is.
With Nathan Prescott, please come to the front office. Thank you.
Go Bigfoot. Is that like our mascot? Okay.
This is a great.
Hi, Mix. Can I get my flash drive? I need some info and space. Hello? Sorry, running late. It's seeing day. I'll meet you in the lot. Looking cool. You'll see. My camera will be ready. See you shortly. I hope so. Right, well,
okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive.
So the dorm's over there. Oh, shoot. There's more pages. Okay, well, I already went through that, so I'm not. Is this a statue?
I bet
the
Blackwell founders would shit cats if they saw today's student body walking around like zombies on their phones.
Oh. Stella. So we have a football team, I guess. Exhibition.
That's so cool that Blackwell is doing a show of Mr. Jefferson's work.
Yeah, they did say he's like a famous, one of the world's most famous.
That's one of his doctors. Famous shots. I love how it captures the moment.
Yeah, I love the art style. Oh, look at the squirrel. I want to take a picture of him. Can I? Yeah. Graffiti.
Clever.
Vortex Club's,
Hello?
Max, I don't feel like talking.
What's wrong?
What's wrong?
Nathan Prescott, little rich bitch kid. He thinks he can own people like his parents own Blackwell. Like he owns the Vortex Club.
Yes, he's a nasty piece of work.
You know him?
Not really. We don't need to tell people
Not
about
really.
It.
I've seen him around.
Sounds like you know way more than that. Max, tell me.
I don't know you, man. Nope, he's just a dick.
Nope, he's just an entitled dick with a lot of money. Not my type.
Somebody needs to take that prick down.
He'll take himself down.
He'll take himself down.
Yeah, history always proves that, right? Just wait for justice, you sheeple.
Did he call me a sheeple? What's a sheeple? Whoa! Is that a drone? Oh yeah, that girl on her tablet all the way over there. Probably what's doing it. There's Evan. I'm gonna talk to Evan. I wanna talk to this girl. No. Alright, well, dormitories for this one. Go to the dormitories. More chill.
Come on, Logan, bring it, bro.
Bring it, bruh. I like that. Way less people over here. Yeah. That's fun.
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive.
Yes, yes you do. Alright, so there's a girl over here. Her phone? I'll read my book.
Oh. Hi, Max.
How are you?
How are you doing?
I'm everyone's therapist today.
I'm by myself reading chick lit. Pretty soon I'll be bonding with Victoria at the Vortex Club.
I think you're better off reading chick lit.
Good point. Now if you'll excuse me.
She is.
Okay.
So we got Logan.
No, bro. You can't take a picture. You gotta wait till Friday's game.
I'm sorry, bro.
No.
Is that Kate? Hi, Kate.
Hi, Kate.
Hey, Max.
You look down.
You look down. You okay?
I'm kind of over humanity today. Sorry to be a drama queen.
Is there anything...
Max, I'd like to be alone, if you don't mind. I'm sorry.
Okay. I tried. That is Zachary.
Football, Max. Big football. Step away.
Okay, dude. That's cool. I didn't think I want to talk to the groundskeeper. He looks a little weird. They're not gonna let me in, I can tell you now. They're just
Oh, look, it's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell.
Yep, it's me.
What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled.
Excuse me. Oh, dude, if I had that gun...
Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving.
Oh.
Oh, wait. Hold that pose. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh yes, Victoria.
Bitch?
I'll get your bony ass out of my way.
Oh. That's how. Paint? Yeah, the paint on them. Sprinklers, maybe.
I could crank the sprinkler up and give Victoria and her clones incentive to beat it. I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel.
Yeah.
I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way.
Just go in here. Oh, yeah.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah. Water on my cashmere.
Oh my god.
Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
And then she goes back over there.
Awesome.
Oh, yeah. Something with the paint can.
Sorry, no paparazzi allowed.
Bitch, what?
Keep walking, hippie.
She looks like a pissed off wet cat, and she's still stylish.
Oh, man, I hate that. I get that feeling all the time, you know? Okay. Can I do anything else? Sweet. Maybe we were supposed to rewind. Oh. Yeah, okay, we have to do something with that paint bucket. No, we gotta get down from there, dude. How about right... No, tamper. Does the guy not see me doing it? Does he not care?
Okay, let's see if this works.
Let's just sit back and relax. Watch her get nailed with some paint. How does it not fall out when he's like holding it?
No.
Sorry, bruh. Those guys are pretty kind of funny.
Okay.
There it is!
Close, but no cigar. They have to be right under the bucket.
Oh, okay, so we have to do this while... No, we have to... We gotta rewind way back. Okay, we gotta turn the sprinklers up. Okay. Turn sprinklers up. And get there before this guy tampered.
Nice, bro.
Got him.
I can't grab that. Samuel is way too close.
So sprinklers are bothered then, that would be temporary.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Sweet.
No way!
Yep.
No
you okay, Victoria?
Oh, Samuel is sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo!
Oh man, poor guy.
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I dry.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches.
Oh, I gotta take a picture of her. Please let that be an option.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
Oh, but if we comfort her, maybe she'd be less of a bitch to us. Oh, but I want to take a picture of her. Let's see if we can make her less of a bitch.
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
It was. But there'll be another.
Well, you always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max. I hope those sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on me. You deserve a better shot. Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck your selfie. Yeah.
That was mean, but pretty funny.
Just one of those days, you know?
I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
Yeah. Au revoir.
Okay.
Victoria probably played me. I should have played her. Better get to my room before I find Warren.
Oh yeah, we need to get our flash drives though. Forgot about that. Oops. Oh, more music. Please don't be copyrighted. We'll look around here later. I'm sure there'll be another option.
Victoria is going to be pissed we took so long.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Is this our dorm? Max's room. I'll look into the music. Hopefully I'll be able to not have to mute it.
Home sweet home. My favorite cocoon.
Okay, we don't have time to lie down.
Warren even left me a little message with his flash drive. He's such a goofball.
Oh, he has such a crush on her. To Max or whom it may concern, the cinematic contents of this flash drive are of a graphic, life-altering, controversial nature. The collection has been downloaded with the greatest care and most discriminating viewer. I congratulate you on your taste and eagerly await your in-depth reviews of Cannibal Holocaust and Ultra Vixens. Peace, Warren G. Cannibal Holocaust. Power strip. I'm gonna turn my lights off. Mom sent us a text. Max, your principal sent me an email that you told some tall tales about Blackwell Honor Student. Is that true? Principal says that was a serious false charge and is worried you're telling stories. Call me ASAP so we can talk about this. Mom. Oh, bullshit. Yeah, he owns the school. What are we gonna do? I should have just not said anything.
Max and Chloe, best friends forever. Who even says that anymore? I'm going to have to call Chloe eventually and find out what she'll say. The longer I wait, the worse it'll be.
You're not gonna play me.
Idiot.
Let's use our computer, see what's going on.
I am so addicted
to
this
site.
Look at these vintage beauties.
Is that an actual thing? Look at the fake Google Chrome. It's got fake ad block. That's awesome.
Warren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real
Max,
friend
Max, thanks
here.
For the email and copy of Jefferson's class notes. Now I shall never stop sending messages of gratitude. I also have a rather ecstatic collection of TV cult classic fucked up films that on a fat flash drive if you ever want to check them out. Thanks again for the help. I'm a scientist more than an artist. Now, can you quickly explain to me how a camera works? Be seeing you. Warren G. Okay. So, where's our flash drive?
Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note.
Hey girl, borrowed your flash drive so we can watch some flicks while I study. If you need it back, just track me down in my room. Okay. So
great.
Dana
now has... I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room.
Cookies.
I love that Mom sent me a fat box of chocolate coconut bites for my birthday. And slipped in a $200 gift certificate.
Oh.
She sure knows how to make a sad birthday happy.
Tell me the truth, you're rotten there.
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell.
So stupid.
Wait. Isn't that like the vortex? Symbol?
Answer, you wuss.
I don't know what that is, actually.
Hey, Juliet.
You are ridiculous.
Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
Calm down.
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Who has a lock on the outside?
How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Mason?
Juliet Mason.
That was truly sad. Thanks for your concern, Max Caulfield. By the way, Juliet Watson.
Watson.
Hey, Juliet.
Okay, skip.
Oh, yes, Max.
Skip.
This is so stupid.
Juliet Watson.
Juliet Watson, you be nice.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do.
Thanks. I locked Dana in because she was sexting Zach, my boyfriend. Unbelievable.
Why don't you go deal with Zach? He's outside playing football.
If you don't let me out, I will scream.
Would Dana do that?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything. But I bet Victoria
I'm not
did.
Letting her out until she tells
okay,
the truth.
Well, we need in there, so... Where are we?
Hey, Juliet.
Oh, yes, Max.
So stupid.
Juliet Watson.
Juliet
nice.
I'm flattered.
Of course.
Thanks.
You are ridiculous.
How did you know?
How do you know?
Victoria Chase. You know her.
You could say that. But why would Dana go after your boyfriend?
According to Victoria,
so
Dana
loud.
Would do anything to date a quarterback.
According.
She saw the
Max.
Okay, so we need to get in there some other way.
I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
Oh, in Victoria's room. Okay. Wonder if this map has something.
Welcome to Black Hill.
Victoria Chase 221 across from mine. Why is my room so small? Okay, so this one, I guess, they share. Oh, no, they're across. Okay, so she's across from my room. Yeah, I like how those three popular girls get bigger rooms. It's fun. Okay. That's always great. Victoria's room. Oh, it's open. How convenient. What does it say? Be the change you wish to see.
Oh, Victoria,
Gandhi.
Give me a fucking break.
Should put the Gandhi on there. Okay, the proof is in this room. I don't want to get caught in here.
Ouch. Well, at least she puts her photographs out there. Unlike me.
Okay, so she got denied from, like, an art thing that she tried to submit to. Look at that camera.
She's actually got a classic medium format camera with some awesome prime lens. Whoa, I had no idea Victoria's parents owned the Chase space. Color me impressed.
Let's use her tablet.
Is she going to get a 3D printer for her dorm room? Maybe I will join her posse.
Why does she need a 3D printer?
They should call this series aloof. Cold and... Yes, I get it. Enter the Vortex Club. Okay, if I did wear expensive jewelry, I would wear this for sure.
Okay. Yes.
I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
Taylor, it's so sad to inform you that I totally punked Juliet and Dana just now. All I had to do was mention Juliet and I saw a nasty sex from Dana on Zach's phone. The dumbass believes me and ass with a Z. And so I expected there to be some dorm rampage and Juliet deserves for this sledding Zach away from me. As for Dana, who gives a shit? Get out your popcorn. XXBC. Where's the printer? There was no print option. Was there not printing that? Press the space bar. Okay, fake.
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
We could keep looking around here, but nah. I was really afraid Victoria's gonna be like, what are you doing in there the second I walk out? Oh boy. Hey, Juliet.
Juliet, read this.
Just put your phone away. Oh my gosh.
Of course.
I'm an asshole.
Bitch.
I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
All right. Dana. Stomp him, Bigfoot.
Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
Okay, so I can rewind, so let's just look around.
I can't even imagine what life would be like being a cheerleader. Dana takes her Blackwell spirit seriously.
Clearly. There's stuff on the table. Pregnancy tests.
That looks like a home pregnancy test.
Max, that's mine. Thank you.
Oh, is she pregnant?
You're not helpful. You're just nosy. I think you better go.
All right, let's rewind that. It's clear that she's like pregnant now.
Nice, Max. You hurt her feelings by being so damn nosy again. But I could rewind and make it up to her.
Okay, we'll talk to her in a second. Let's take her flash drive.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
Dude, don't do that.
I better make sure everything is still in there.
What's on here?
I think Warren forgot to hide the Party Buster folder. Not that I would open it no matter how tempting. I have my self-respect.
Oh my gosh. Max. Okay. Oh, Jesus. That seems like one of those, like, not great.
Of course a popular cheerleader like Dana would have a million friends.
Oh, look at all those friends.
So fascinating to get a peek at Dana's social media friends. World. And yes, Max, so terribly wrong. This is both sad and pathetic.
I can't read that. Dana, I suck at writing, but I thought I should write this so you might not hate my dumbass forever. I know I act like a tough jock around everybody, but I never had to act around you. I'm not the kind of man you deserve. I saw how you saw how I pissed out. If you need any money, let me know. XO Logan.
It would be a cool sticker without the words.
I saw like a vortex.
Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Dana.
Rumor about you.
I'm not trying to be nosy, but I heard a rumor about you.
What? Who told you I was pregnant?
Nobody important. They just acted like it was bullshit. I just wanted you to know.
It's like a goddamn reality show around here. Can you keep a secret, Max?
I can always rewind and I want to see if she actually thinks.
You're pregnant. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have.
Yeah, me neither. But I did. Anyway.
Oh. What about the other?
Deadbeat Dad? You can catch him on the 40-yard line this Friday. And it's not Zachary.
Who's
it? So it's not her boyfriend.
And you don't have to tell me. In fact, you better not.
I like your spirit, Max. Anyway, you better get that flash drive so Warren has an excuse to bug you.
Wait, I want to see what the other options do.
Hey, Dana.
Serious.
Dana.
What?
Nobody.
It's like a.
Okay, I want to go through this. I want to see what she says.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
That'd be Dad.
Who? No, not my business, right?
Sorry to pry. It's not my business. And I won't be at the game Friday. Not much school spirit, I guess.
I like your spirit, Max.
Okay. Let's go back in. I think we're just standing there.
Hey, Dana.
Cool. Okay, heard the rumor about you.
What? Nobody.
Of course.
Of course.
I was pregnant.
Oh.
Was.
Oh. What about the other?
Deadbeat Dad? You can catch him on the 40 yard.
Okay, we've gone through all of these.
I like.
Okay. Maternity book? Ooh.
Good lord. Dana really was on her own.
Don't really mind waiting out here forever. I love this parking lot. I can count all the cars. The more it takes, the longer I take on my way. Bye. I can count all these cars. I like him. That's funny. Let's go. Okay, is this Zachary? I can't remember.
Fuck this shit.
Oh, Jesus.
Ow.
What?
Damn, I better rewind.
Yeah, let's get her out of the way.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
She doesn't even care. Your actions will. By the way, thanks, but we're not friends. Okay. Wait, how is that gonna have consequences? What is... Is that really gonna... I don't wanna... Maybe it was talking about the text I just got. This is Zachary, so it was the other guy.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
What was the other guy's name? It was the quarterback. Not Zachary.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Yeah, what's this dude's problem? Intervene.
Hey! Why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
I hope you do.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Okay.
Anytime, Kate.
Anytime.
I felt like an everyday hero.
Okay, I felt like an everyday hero, but something. Sorry. I didn't know she was gonna say something. Wow, this is a long video. Okay, more music. Hopefully, it's not copyrighted, but I'm sorry if the sound of the video just goes, like, you know, for a second. That's why. There's Warren on the car. I'm not gonna skip. Oh, there's Julia.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
I don't get it. How could Zach and Victoria do that to me?
Hi, Juliet.
Zach.
How are you doing?
Zach.
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry about Zach.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zach yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he texted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
Right.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Damn. What's this say?
I wonder how long before Samuel has to repaint that.
It's hard. Can't read that. It's hard. Something with an M, maybe? Yeah.
Come on over here.
Missing
please.
Person. I'm coming, Warren. Look at this car.
Look at Warren in his Wayback Machine. He's a brave man.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
Oh, my rejection.
No problem.
Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Thanks. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Something. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Oh, dude, I should have taken one. It's okay. I don't want to talk.
I don't want to talk about it.
Jeez, you're a little miss sensitive today.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't push your luck, Warren. Not in the mood today.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
Oh, he that pirated does sound all better the movies? Than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Wait. What is that? Have we seen it? Sure.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
What? I'm not gonna say that. Faster, pussycat. Kill, kill. How so?
How so?
Sensitive usually means won't be having sex with you.
Damn.
Oh god. You need a sensitive woman to kick your ass.
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week.
Oh my gosh.
But you seem distracted.
Dude. I need to talk.
I need to talk to somebody. Just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren. This is between you and me. Not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Gosh. I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal. Now. Answer me, bitch.
What are you talking about,
What
dude?
Are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me. I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back,
Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Did he headbutt him?
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal, or that whore in the bathroom!
What about all those guys just walking around back there? I can do everything.
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
No! No, I got this!
Damn. Oh.
Get in, Max!
What are all those people
Get
over there
their
doing?
Punk asses! Like... Out of there now! Don't even try to run!
Start kicking
clothes. Nobody!
Oh, and there's a security guard. Please don't play copyright music. Hey, another Illuminati.
Is messed up.
Hey.
And dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe.
Yeah, thanks, Chloe.
After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield.
Oh, copyright music. Don't play while they're talking.
Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing.
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I
thought it would be quiet here.
Oh, jeez.
Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess so.
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course.
Of course. It's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
Oh my gosh. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Yeah,
not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it at my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Is that the end of the episode? If so, I mean, that was a good end. Okay. Welcome home, baby.
Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
Home, shit, home. Man, it's a long episode, wow. I didn't know these were that long, I don't remember. Not safe for work. Said around the post. It's funny. Everybody lies, no exceptions. Things like a man.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill out zone. My step fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door.
It's funny.
Put on some music while I medicate.
Power strip. Oh, hey, that's cool. Oh, he turned the stereo on. Oh, this is gonna have some. Just know there's gonna be great music on this. I'm not gonna search her desk, that's messed up. Actually, I am, because I can always rewind.
I think this junk swallowed her discs.
Are her discs in there? Oh, let's use her laptop, we use the Reynolds.
She looks super happy. She looks super sad.
Oh.
She looks super stoned.
Okay.
Houston, we have the power. But we need to find a disc to play.
Search?
And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross.
Oh.
Dude, you broke my glass.
Okay. Breaking your glass? No, I'm sorry.
Thanks.
Okay,
We had such a blast drawing these together.
We drew those? That's cool.
Old cardboard boxes.
Okay, broke my glass.
There's gotta be ways, a way
Thanks.
To... Maybe if we move that? How about in the
closet?
Oh,
this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair. Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her.
Suck it. Fuck all shit life. Was this like her heights? Oh, it was.
Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height.
Dad is gone. Oh, did her dad die?
Nothing but junk in this suitcase.
Oh, maybe in here. Hey, some music. Who's that? Is that?
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
Who? That's Rachel Amber.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot.
Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened?
Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know?
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Depressing. Alright. More copyright. I'm really hoping that it doesn't have an issue. Yeah, she's smoking weed, okay. For a second, I thought it was a cigarette. No.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Okay. You blaze and be alone. Of course, the music's gonna follow us. Okay, this is the bathroom. I don't know what we're gonna put in here. Goodbye to my Santa
Monica dream. I wonder if Chloe is taking those pills. I hope she's okay.
Those are antidepressants. That's what Phloxacin is.
I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me. This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products.
Okay. Okay, this music's... Oh, Jesus.
This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today.
The bird hit the window? Yeah. Kind of confidence for that. I don't want to get in trouble for letting a bird into their house. Maybe I shouldn't. Even if the bird does hit the window. Okay, I don't want to go through their parents' stuff. I want to be super nosy. Hopefully this music isn't copyrighted. Now?
Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days. Nope. Someone locked it from the other side.
Thanks again for helping me. No problem, that guy's an asshole. Yeah. I don't know what's up with Kate, but...
I haven't seen this place in 5 years.
Doing.
Seems like forever.
5 years.
I should be able to find the tools I need here.
Okay. Open drawer.
Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell.
He's the dad?
He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get?
Oh my gosh.
Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've gotta be shitting me.
Oh my gosh. I think this is 2013 when this game takes place. This game came out in 2015. It's a lot of guns.
Hmm. One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat.
Don't think so. Someone else. Maybe someone stole it. Yeah, those are the tools we need.
Boom, precision screwdrivers. Except, I can't reach them.
Okay, maybe this will knock it down. Yeah.
That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach.
You could stick your hand in there. But there's this. Turn the washing machine on. I have a pack of those tools at home. Cool. Spooky. It's probably bad for the machine.
Yes! You have mad skills, Max.
Okay, wait.
I've got the tools.
I
should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks.
I don't call 911. There's a TV in there. Oh, no, not messing with the TV. Just kidding, I really want to know. We can rewind after. I want to figure out what's on there.
What the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals?
Really?
This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this?
What the hell, dude? So fucked up. Close it.
No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
I wonder if his password's written somewhere. They're gonna fall. Max, can you get anything?
Butterfingers!
Can you actually pull anything down? What's in here? Poop. Trophy. A car. That's right.
Cool. Now it's opened.
Let's go upstairs. Wrong way. That's funny. Hey, Chloe. What's up? Fixing the tools. Fix them up.
So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah,
could probably.
I just took them today.
One of them.
Let me see.
Online.
Wait.
They're not that hard to find.
I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life.
Hella saved my life.
Now tell me the truth, Max.
That's funny. I was there.
I was there. Hiding in the corner. Damn. You're a ninja. A ninja would have cut Nathan's head
off. You looked right past it.
I just took a butterfly photo. That is so badass. Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun. So, did you recognize me?
Not at all.
Not at all. Your hair and clothes are so different. I hope so. I'm sure this is all so weird to you after coming back. Like you said, it's been that kind of day. So you must have overheard our conversation.
A bit.
Just a bit. There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel. Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it. Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Like who?
Like who? Like anybody. Stop stalling, sister. The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me. The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash from Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him. I didn't mention you at all. Swear. Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max.
This is a really long video. Fun rendering this.
I know it was your birthday last month.
What is she? Oh, I like that sleeve.
This
really
was cool. My real father's camera. I want you to have it. That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this. Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool? Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet. Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
Oh,
you're
my
crazy. Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance. Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera.
Can we do a both? Whoa, wait.
This day couldn't get any stranger.
Let's see it. Is it a good picture? Do I not get to know,
this
really?
Song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
She's so awkward.
Yo, turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
I thought that
Dude,
was
the music's not even on.
In my house.
Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Hide?
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe,
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in now. Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing! Give me a minute!
Don't
really keep her whining, so there's time.
Chloe!
I'm coming!
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing! Give me a minute!
I'm not a kid anymore. I can't hide under the bed. Where else?
Chloe!
I'm coming!
What are you doing?
There is nowhere else.
Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing!
Oh.
Give me a minute!
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now!
Hi.
Please!
1 second! My bra is stuck!
I'm not screwing around, soldier! Chloe,
soldier.
Open this door.
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh, God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh, yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order.
Whose is it?
I don't want to get her in trouble, but I don't want to get myself in trouble and make him, like, hate me. Oh. Let's step in. We can always rewind, right?
I'm sorry. That was my joint.
Well, well. I don't like strangers in my home, especially dopers. So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now, do you?
Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Because you're such a badass, Max, let me show you my new toy.
I swear she pulls out the gun.
I'm Price. Chloe Price. Bang!
It
Jesus,
is.
Put that thing down.
You're so
relax, sister. It's not even loaded. Yet.
I thought you believed in gun control.
Yes, I believe I should control the gun. It's the men who need to be checked. You trust Nathan or David? Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win.
What?
Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
Okay.
That did not go well for me.
I could
rewind
it.
If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
I do, but let's see what happens. Any faster, come on. Let's see what happens if I...
Chloe!
Oh,
I'm
it went
coming.
All the way back here.
Okay. Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just
see
let
what happens
me
if we hide.
Now. Please.
1 second. Stop treating me and my mom like we're your family platoon.
Hey, leave Joyce out of this.
I wish you'd leave Joyce. Like now.
Oh. No. No. Cool. Not cool with that.
I'm sorry. I care about your mother, and you just keep pushing me.
Don't touch me again, asshole. That's the last time. Or I'll bring the cops in here so fast.
You're not that dumb.
I'd be smart to have you busted.
Chloe, someday you'll grow up.
She's gonna be like, oh, why didn't you protect me, Max? And I'm gonna be like, well, I didn't want to get in trouble for myself.
Hey, you okay?
Welcome to the real step douches of Arcadia Bay.
I'm sorry.
For what? He would have been a bigger dick if he caught you in here.
Yeah.
That's hard to believe. Anyway, let's sneak out the window.
Okay.
There is one cool place we can go to in this hick hole.
I think that was that bad.
David was such a mean bastard to Chloe. What if I had stepped up to help?
Then I ruined my own reputation even more with him and could potentially lose my scholarship. Okay, I'm happy with that decision. Let's go. I know Chloe got hurt, but it was just a slap. It's not gonna kill her. Let's go, Chloe. Wow, we're still going. So long ass episode.
I haven't been here in forever. So why do I feel like I was just here?
The dream, man.
This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today.
Yes. exactly. Is Chloe here with us? Oh, she's gotta be. Where else should we? I owe you. Thanks for today. I'll call back later, okay? I swear. No problem. You still have to tell me your big secret, Keck. Dude, he's got such a... Oh my god.
Earth is so lucky, they can always escape.
Just for Beverly, we're not getting with Max. Clearly likes her.
Sure you don't want to be alone?
Sit down if you want.
Oh, she is pissed at me.
Are you pissed at me?
I just wanted some backup.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
Well, we can
I'm
make
sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
We've been friends.
You have
since
to
life.
Live with him. Has he always been this
forever.
Way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
He freaked out on poor Kate Marsh today.
I know her. She's cool. Only that prick would bully her.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
I wanted to.
You know, I wanted to, but I realized I have enough mystery in my life.
I'd like to find out. I bet he's got some serious porn in there. Good thing you didn't look. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
I knew you didn't know. Chloe, your house is under surveillance.
What are you talking about?
The mouse is
there are cameras
sink,
all over the house. I saw it on a monitor in the
it's
garage.
Pretty, though.
I knew it. He's so hella fucking paranoid. I'll keep this a secret for now.
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
Even yours or what's Nathan's? I don't know which one's intruding more. Even yours.
Even yours?
Not anymore.
So what do you have on Nathan?
Oh, we get both.
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
How much?
How much do you owe?
$3,000 plus interest. And before I could get a chunk of that from Nathan, he dosed my drink with some shit.
God, Chloe. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
Oh, okay, so he did.
Chloe, that is so fucked up. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Oh, good thing you notified the principal. I feel safer already.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max.
Yeah.
This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
Oh.
my kid!
Oh, we're in this again? Okay.
Why is this happening to me? Why am I here again?
There's a ghost deer. I want it. It will be mine. Name first. The ghost.
Chloe's still up there?
Whoa! That didn't hit me. Why is it?
Max, don't fuck around. Rewind.
Timeline figured out.
The tornado is headed straight for the town.
Yeah. Yes, it is, Mac.
Chloe, you're here. I'm back. Oh my lord, this is real. It's real. Oh man, this sucks.
Max, what's going on? You totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years. We just zoned.
No, I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in
the
air.
This is one of the 5.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But high? Right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day.
Don't think I do. I always love that when people say, oh, you just need to get high, dude.
What is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max, start from the beginning.
Yeah, now you believe me,
Tell me everything.
Now you believe me, Chloe. How did nobody see those cameras? Oh, there's Chloe. Rachel? Oh, their mom. Oh, that's Kate. try to cheer her up. A puppy with a joke. Principal. There's girls' names on them. Okay, guys. That was episode 1 of Life is Strange. Wow. Like I said, I played this a really long time ago, but I don't remember more than at least half of this. I don't remember like any of it. This game is tense, and I love it. So, thank you all very much for watching this video. Hopefully I won't have to mute the audio when there's music. I'm gonna look into it and see if there's, you know, copyright issues. Hopefully there won't be, because it's in the game, and most of the time songs that are in games don't have issues. But we will see. So thank you all very much for watching. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Goodbye.